Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Good morning, church. Good morning, everyone. Happy Sunday. Welcome to today's Sunday school. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, Lord, we want to thank you once again. We want to bless you. We worship you. We thank you for bringing us together to learn at your feet. Father, we pray that, Lord, as we are going into the word today, we pray that you shall teach us yourself in the mighty name of Jesus. Pray that, Lord, I shall not speak of my own words, but of yours in Jesus' name. And I pray these words shall germinate richly in our hearts in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray for those that are still on their way. Pray that shall hasten their footsteps in the mighty name of Jesus. And I pray that these words shall not stand against us in judgment day in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. We bless your holy name. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Good morning once again. Today's lesson is lesson 23. Lesson 23. The topic for today is modern day idolatry. Modern day idolatry. Our memory verse shall be taken from Matthew 22, verse 37. Matthew 22, verse 37, I read, Jesus said unto him, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy might. I repeat, Jesus said unto him, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. Matthew 22, verse 37. Our lesson text will be taken from Exodus chapter 20. Exodus chapter 20, verse 3-5. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourself a carved image, any likeness of anything that is in the heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. You shall not bow down to them nor serve them. For I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children of the third and fourth generations of those who hate me. Amen. So today's topic again, modern day idolatry. So we'll be talking about what are some of those things that are considered idols, even as Christians. We're not even talking about people that are not Christians now. The things that we as Christians, we sometimes unknowingly, idolize. So that's what the topic today is all about. And I pray God would help us to examine ourselves and, change in any way that we might have felt that, we're, idolizing or we've kind of gone astray according to the plan of God. Pray that God will help us in Jesus' name. An idol is anything that replaces the one and only true God in our lives. It can be anything that appeals to our own heart more than God does, and anything that takes a significant amount of our time, leaving us with little or no time to spend with Him. While the scriptures condemns idolatry in strong terms, in Jeremiah 12, verse 6, many Christians engage in idol worship today without knowing it. Many Christians engage in idol worship today without knowing it. I think essentially the way that we can probably identify some of those idols in our lives is anything that is not done in moderation. Anything that is not done in moderation. And, we all have individual, habits, lifestyle. But it could be, food. Some people just like to eat too much, to the point that they can't even fast. It could be, material things. We're going to go through some of those things, but this list, they are not exclusive because it's just to kind of help us to identify those things. And, we would like to also discuss on this later on today, and I hope we'll have the time to do that. So lesson outline, form of modern-day idolatry, we'll talk about some of those things, and then consequences of modern-day idolatry. Forms of modern idolatry, unlike the past, where idol worship is bound down to statues and objects typical of pagans in many cultures, modern-day idol worship is expressed through various insatiable pursuits and cravings of man, driven by his sinful nature. This shifts all the attention to man, leaving God out of the equation. Let's read Isaiah 42, verse 8. Isaiah 42, verse 8. It says, I am the Lord, that is my name, and my glory I will not give to another, nor my praise to carved images. It is also expressed by portraying and painting God contrary to sound and total biblical precept, but revealing him to suit personal values and ideologies. You know, I do believe that, man, of course, we have the free will to do anything we want to do. And I think that free will, God gave that to us ever since man fell. When man ate from the tree of knowledge of good and evil, we begin to have that free will to do anything that we can do or that we want to do. But the abuse of that free will, I believe, can lead to those, idol worshiping. Quite often, modern-day idolatry takes the form of, number one, self-worship. What is self-worship? Self-worship is expressed through aggressive pursuit and realization of goals and dreams in which God is excluded. You are so full of yourself, you begin to worship yourself. You think everything that you've accomplished, if it's by your own strength, by your own might, by your own wisdom, you're not ascribing glory to God. We see that in the Bible, Nebuchadnezzar, when he just looked at everything that he has done and he said, "Oh, I have done all of these things. It is by my might." Never for once, ascribe the glory to God. And we all know what happened. God had to bring him down. He had to bring him low to the barest form of, human being. He was actually eating grass, So anything that we have accomplished in this world, we need to know that it's God that has given it to us. Anything, whatever we are today, it is God that has given it to us. The moment we start to exclude God, then we begin to self-worship ourselves. We begin to idolize ourselves. So the express true aggressive pursuit and realization of goals and dreams in which God is excluded. Again, like I said, all of these things, they are good. Of course, we should be ambitious. We have goals, we have dreams, but the abuse of these things, the abuse of all of this so-called good things that we aspire to become, when we exclude God, it becomes self-worship. Number two, materialism. Great or excessive regard for worldly possessions. Some people, and it's nothing wrong, they just like good things, flashy things, expensive things, to the point that they, rather than give to God, they will rather spend that money on that shoe, that bag, that clothes. That's just their lifestyle. They live this extravagant lifestyle, and they forget about God. That God is the one that has even given them those things. Again, the abuse of all of these things, when you're the extremity of some of this of our actions, could lead to the idol worshiping. Let's read 1 Corinthians 7:31. It says, "Okay, yes, go ahead, ma'am."
"And yet I use this word as nothing, abusing it, for the fashion of this word passes away."
Yeah, for the form of this word is passing away. If Solomon, who is you know, regarded as the richest man, the wealthiest man in the world. If Solomon in the book of Ecclesiastes could say vanity upon vanity, all is vanity. You know, all of these things, all of these our pursuits, everything that we're doing in this life is going to pass away. This world is temporarily. It's going to pass away. So material things is one of the idol that, you know, we as Christians, we sometimes find in our lives. Another Bible passage I want us to read is 1 John 2:15. I'll read that quickly. It says, do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in me. So, yes, we live in this world, but we are not of this world. Loving the world means that the love of the Father is not in us. We cannot serve two idols. We cannot serve God and serve mammon. You know, our pastor was saying that at the workers' meeting yesterday. Another one is pride and ego. Pride and ego, which often takes the form of obsession with careers, business, to increase social status. You know, there are some people, they're so knowledgeable in their field, in their career, that they think they know too much. They know more than everyone. No one is, you know, they've accomplished that highest level of knowledge. But the Bible says even the wisest man, you know, the wisdom of the wisest man is foolishness unto God. You cannot even, you're not even wiser than the devil. Let's even put it out. No matter how you think you're wise, you're not even wiser than the devil, let alone God. So, you know, pride, you know, having pride, having ego of the things that no one can talk to you. You know, you so much take so much full of yourself that, you know, it's what I've done. I am who I am. I have made myself, you know, you see those kind of people maybe when they come to church, the way they even, you know, carry themselves. Some they're even feel too big to even praise God, you know, to dance in the church of God. You know, like you can see the way they walk, you know, the way they talk, you know, they talk in big vocabularies, you know. So, and again, none of those things is wrong. And that's why I said, you know, God will search our hearts, you know, because it's individual. It's individual. Just because someone has a PhD or, you know, is a CEO of a company, you know, can still be humble. So, you know, this is really individual. Let's not judge anyone. But, you know, we all know ourselves. We all know where our weaknesses are. And I pray God will help us in Jesus' name. Amen. You know, the Bible says pride comes before destruction. You know, pride comes before destruction. Let us read Ecclesiastes 2:21-23. Just to buttress that point. Ecclesiastes 2:21-23.
For there is a man whose labor is in wisdom, and in knowledge, and in equity. Yet to a man that hath not labored therein, shall he also his vanity and his great knowledge. For what hath man of all his labor, and of the vexation of his heart, wherein he hath labored?
Yeah, 21 to 23.
Sorrows and his travail grief. Yea, his heart taketh not rest in the night. This is also vanity.
See, this is Solomon also, you know, talking in there. Proverbs 8:13. Proverbs 8:13. I'll read: the fear of the Lord is to hate evil, pride and arrogance in the evil way, and the perverse mouth I hate. The fear of the Lord is to hate evil. So, again, all pointing to that pride and ego being that idol that some Christians have. You know, in the Bible says, what shall profit a man, you know, if he gains the whole world You know, pride can make us gain the whole world, but we can also lose our soul. Idolizing fellow humans. When we idolize our fellow human being, referencing renowned individuals above God, music stars, actors, footballers, ministers of God, politicians, spouses, and so on, when respect is good, honor is good, even the Bible says in regards to men of God that we should honor and respect them, but this should not be above God. This should not be above God. Some people, in terms of sports now, and I'm a sports fan. Their team is playing, and it's at the same time that they have to go to church. They'll rather stay home to watch their team play. No, they'll rather stay home to watch their team play so that they can cheer their own. They say, okay, I'll do online, and it's even easier now. It's easier to not come to church and just say, okay, I'll stay at home, I'll do online, because we all know what we've went through in the past. So, or it could even be like, a music star, actor, like we just so much love them that even if anybody says one negative thing about them, we're there to like defend our whole lives. Be like, I can do anything it's like, let's be immoderate to some of these things, let's be moderate to some of these things. Having argument. You like sometimes when you have it, maybe you're trying to defend someone and you began to sin even in that argument of trying to defend, pastor or a preacher or, an actor or something. And you start to sin and you start to even say things that are not godly. I pray God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Naturalism and the power of science. This cling to the illusion that man is the lord of his world due to scientific and technological breakthroughs. Let us read 2 Peter 3:10 to 13. 2 Peter 3:10 to 13. See, so even if you, with all of the technologies and all the achievements that this world has done, man rules this world, but let us know that this world is going to pass away. It's going to pass away. And like I said again, if Solomon, who is the wealthiest man on earth, could say vanity upon vanity, all is vanity, there's nothing that we say as human beings that we've accomplished in this world. It says, this cling to the illusion that man is the lord of this world due to scientific and technological breakthroughs. So let us understand that. And this has a lot to do with science, like some people, they have all this scientific belief about how the world came about, and even humans, and so many things, and all of these things, and they disregard, what God has done, even creation. We forget that it's God that has even put us in this earth. God is the one that put us. We are not, yes, we think we rule this world, but really, it's God that has allowed us to rule this world. And number six is self-indulgence. Through alcohol, drugs, excessive watching of TV, excessive and abnormal use of social media, clubbing, and gambling, among other things. The things that we do. Again, I mean, as a Christian, some of these things we know that it's not Christian standard, but unfortunately, you know, we still do some of these things. And watching TV, you know, some of us, we like, you know, we'll watch series and episodes of movies or shows, but we cannot spend like 1 hour to watch like a Christian movie, you know, that would edify us, that would lift up our spirit, but we can spend hours and hours in watching all of these different shows. You know, excessive and abnormal use of social media. That is, you know, I think all of us can relate with this. We all use social media in one form or the other. But how do we, how has this affected us in a way that it has become an idol in our lives? I would actually like us to talk about that. Excessive use of social media. How has this affected us as Christians in today's world? I don't know if anybody wants to say something. You want to say something, sir? Okay. Please, can you give...
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I would have said that excessive use of social media to be an idolization is the fact that when one keeps too much time watching a certain program, even though sometimes one might be making mistake that, oh, before I come to church to be part of this congregation, I have to quickly watch this program. And by the time you finish that program, instead of you to be here to be part of this teaching, you will know that even praise and worship is gone before the person gets settled, gets into go slow or a lot of, and that has been a lot of distractions, and that can keep us from the blessing that one might get for that day.
Okay, all right. Yeah, one more person, and then we'll still have time to talk.
Something that was just coming to my mind, like how we can deal with this issue of idolizing social media. And when you look at fasting, like we fast for food, like sometimes we intentionally, the church declare fasting, we abstain ourselves from food so that we can focus on God and then come back to it. I think one of the ways, we can't say everybody should go away from social media, no more social media, because one way or the other, it's, you know, beneficial, and it can also help for me. But from time to time, let's do social media fast. Just tell yourself, throughout today, I'm not going to go on social media, or, you know, for the next 1 week, I'm going to, and we just have to individually examine ourselves and know how we can cut some of these things so that it doesn't become an idol to us.
Amen. Okay. Because of time, we can talk more about it after. Yes, I do. I think we've both spoken well, both speakers. Social media can be an idol. And even like we said, our phone, which we use for our social media, can be an idol. I'm not sure if some of us have experienced this. Maybe we lost our phone, or maybe our phone is dead. We are like so frantic. Like it's like we feel like we can't deal with life anymore. It's like, for that, maybe, I don't know, an hour. I remember I had lost my phone, and for a couple of days, I didn't have my phone. I felt horrible. Like, you know, like, what is going on? Something is missing. I can't, you know. So, you know, going back to the social media fast, we can't even have phone fast. You know, I mean, maybe, like, I just don't want to touch my phone. I just don't want to touch it for, you know, this period of time, so that we don't feel too, like, clinched to it, and we don't feel addicted to it. If something, God forbid, something happens to our phone, you know, We can't do anything else. We can't even function properly. And I pray God will help us in Jesus' name. Let's read 1 Corinthians 10, verse 31. 1 Corinthians 10, verse 31 says, amen. Everything that we do, let's do it to the glory of God. Everything. Everything that we do, let's do to the glory of God. Pray God will help us in Jesus' name. And real quickly, the part B of this lesson is consequences of modern day idolatry. Number one is deviation from the laws and teachings from the laws and teachings of the Lord. 2 Timothy 4 verse 3 to 4, it just basically says that, you know, people would not, you know, endure the sound doctrine of, of God. Instead, you know, they would now begin to create their own doctrine, even create their own teachers. You know, when you begin to deviate from the laws and teaching of the Lord. Number two, loss of zeal for the things of God. You know, you begin to have, you don't have zeal to do godly things anymore. You know, it doesn't interest you anymore. Number three, generational departure from God. So there will be a generational departure, which means it's not just only you. You know, let's look at idol worshiping as a religion, as a culture. And it's something that can be passed on. So even you as an individual, if you're not careful, you know, there's those kind of idols in you, you can pass that on to your, you know, children, you know, to your generations, you know, and it can be a family culture. You know, there are some people, they have that family culture of just idolizing all these expensive things. It's just part of their culture. And there are some people, it's their mouth. In their family, they can talk to you. Talk one thing, they say 10 things because it's been passed on to them, you know. Like respect, they don't know how to respect men of God or people. Like all those things can be passed on. You know, it can be, and it can gradually become generational departure from God. Eternal separation from God. You know, we can also just be eternally separated from God. And lastly, incurring a divine curse. Incurring a divine curse. Let us read Daniel 4, 30 to 33. Incurring a divine curse. Daniel 4:30 to 33.
King's mouth. There fell a voice from heaven saying, O King Nebuchadnezzar, to thee it is spoken, the kingdom is departed from thee, and they shall drive thee from men, and thy dwelling shall be with the beast of the field. They shall make thee to eat grass as oxen, and seven times shall pass over thee, until thou know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men, and giveth it to whomsoever he will. The same hour was the thing fulfilled upon Nebuchadnezzar, and he was driven from men, and did eat grass as oxen, and his body was wet with the dew of heaven, till his hairs were grown like eagles' feathers, and his nails like birds' claws.
Well, you see what happened to Nebuchadnezzar? And I pray none of all these consequences shall be our portion in the mighty name of Jesus. We shall not be cursed in Jesus' name. Amen. But first, you know, let's identify those things that are idols in our lives, and let's work on, you know, getting back to the plan of God for our lives. I pray God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Pray these words shall not stand against us on the judgment day in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Just like our teacher said, the list of all these things that can constitute an idol is just so numerous that inexhaustible. But for the sake of this morning's lesson, they've kind of zoned in on some of them. So what other things can we think of, apart from the ones that were mentioned in this lesson of this morning, that we tend to idolize, maybe knowingly or unknowingly? Praise the Lord. Let's start our discussion from there. And again, if you have any particular question you want to ask, we can also chip that in. Amen. And I'll come back to you.
Praise the Lord. My concern, I'll not be answering your question, but my concern is the pride and ego. And I'm mentioning that because pride is very subtle. Very subtle. So for that sin, pride and we need to take heed to ourselves. We need to constantly check ourselves, because there are a number of things that we do. We don't realize that it is pride. But if you search deep, you will know that pride is at the bottom of that. So that's one thing. So we need to constantly, you know, search ourselves. That's important. Then number two, I think the word is humanism. That's when the human being has become the center of all things. For example, from humanism, I noticed that in American culture, there came this word, my truth. My truth. What is your truth? So now it's not a matter of the truth, but what is your truth individually? And that's humanism. You become the center. You become the center point, the measuring sticks. And so, I just think that we should take it. Anything can become an idol to anybody, so long as God is not the center of it. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you so much, Ma. I need. Mommy raised a very good one. That word, my truth, is so rampant in this generation Gen Z generation. I don't know if, but as parents, as the older generation, please, if you begin to hear any of your children, any of our children using that word, my truth, that's a red flag. Pray God will help us in the name of Jesus.
Praise the Lord. I believe that I'm going to go on to the telephone. The telephone came and took the time of everybody, because sometimes I look at it, they can't even put it down. And back in the days, you just used to go to the corner and use a quarter and call. Today, you lost your phone. I see in my kids, and I see, oh my God, may God help us, because that thing is if you spend time, 1 hour, 2 hours, browsing all over the telephone, and you can't spend 15 or 20 minutes or 30 minutes with God, there's something going somewhere.
Amen. So the social media, the phone, and those gadgets, let's zone in on those ones, because that's more real, especially it's cuts across all board. Kids, adults, grandparents, everybody. So what can we do to make sure that we don't idolize these things, because they are real?
I didn't raise my hand though. But anyway, well, what can I do? Well, like we said, you know, it cuts across grandparents, everyone dream. You're walking on the street, and when there was no cell phone, were we alive? You know, I can't believe it. But, you know, the only thing we can do is encourage ourselves, your children in particular, because they can stay on that thing from morning till midnight. So you just have to take it off them. And then you yourself, too, if you are telling our children to deviate from it, to recite a goal, maybe 30 minutes, 1 hour, what about us? We want to read, it happens to me, too. I want to read the Bible, and I pick up the phone. Before I read the Bible, something pops up. When I was reading, when Brother Ife when I was reading, something just came up, so I couldn't see the screen anymore. That was what I said, you know. And then if you know, you just go. So we have to really, how would I put it? We have to watch it, and you know, like Apostle Paul said, destroy your flesh. You know, tell yourself no when you say that, and then make up your mind, because we say it and then we don't make up our minds, because it's really taking us off God completely. So we have to be determined. You know, that's just the key point.
Amen. I see hands. Let's talk about these things. Amen. Praise the Lord. Sister Ogbolu.
All right. Praise the Lord. So what I see there is everything has to be done in moderation. Right? You have to determine within yourself how much time do I want to dedicate to this thing. Right? But then again, when we say social media, it depends on what you're doing there. Some people are going there just to listen to preaching, because there are pastors, there are churches that are on social media every day. So when you follow those people, you're going to be on social media because you want to listen to them. That being said, there are also businesses that are just mainly on social media. So if you're one of those people and your business is on social media, there's no way you can say, I'm not going to be there, or I want to cut short the time I spend. That means you are cutting short the time you're spending on your business. But having said that also, that should not take us away from God, which is also where the moderation comes in. Even though I do business, when we go to work, we know that it's 7 hours, right? That you're in the office, it's 7 hours. Same thing. If you're working on your business, it cannot be 24/7. There has to be time that you will say, okay, this is where I cut it off. Otherwise, you will also burn yourself out. And before you know it, you are not functional anymore. Praise the Lord. And then the issue of phone and family and children, we're all guilty. Because once you carry your phone, you want to check, what was that message? That's the problem. The only way that is solved is maybe you don't receive notifications. You want to cut off notifications. If you really want to concentrate, then cut off your notifications. And that will help. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I mean, Bible is very clear. Okay, our daddy in the back. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. So I'm trying to make reference to item number 4, which says idolizing fellow humans, and even including ministers of God. So my question is this. You know, sometimes I've, during the revivals, and Christians, they are praying, and then they begin to mention the name of Obadare and Babalola and the rest like that to intercede for them instead of directly to direct our prayers to God. Is it not a way of idolizing them? Yeah.
Very interesting. Hallelujah. Okay. See, praise the Lord. The scripture comes to my mind is this. It says, I think 1 Corinthians 6, verse 12, if I'm sure. It says, all things are lawful to me, but not all things are expedient. All things are lawful to me, but I would never be brought under the power of any. And there's another one that says, not all things edifies, but yet all things can be lawful. So, like what I first said earlier in the morning, we have all these things have been given to us by God to enjoy. We have free will to enjoy them. Family is for our enjoyment. Our job, we can find pleasure in it. We can enjoy it. Social media, the wisdom, the knowledge came from who? From God. It's for our pleasure, it's for our enjoyment. But when we have been brought under the power of social media, when social media is not the one controlling us, not us controlling social media, yes, there are benefits to it. We all agree. But when it is now encroaching into the space of God, when we can no longer, it's easy to abandon the things of God for being on social media,
when all these things are now taking the space of God in our heart, even our children, even our husband, you can idolize your husband. You can idolize your wife. You can idolize your children. And that's what we are saying this morning. I mean, we don't want to go over the lesson again. Like it has been pointed out here this morning. Anything can be idolized. Anything at all can be idolized. And I pray God will help us in the mind. You can even idolize a man of God. If care is not taken, that man of God can take the space of God, the place of God in our life. God is a jealous God. He would never share his glory with anything or with anybody. And I pray God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's rise up. Let's rise up. It's a food for thought. Let's search our heart. We can justify everything and anything we do. Yes, we have reasons to be on the social media. Yes, we have every reason to use the internet. Yes, we should love our children. Yes, we should love our husband. But the moment these things take the place of God, there is a problem. And I pray, let's rise up. Let's search our heart. What is it? What is that thing that is taking the place of God in my heart? Lord, help me. Is it food? Yes, you can idolize food. What is that thing? Is it my husband? Is it my children? Is it my job? Lord, help me. Help me. Help me. Help me, oh God. Is it your money? Is it your wealth? Lord, help me. That I will not give my heart to any of these idols in the name of Jesus. This world will pass away. Everything in it. But the only thing that stands sure is God. Lord, help me. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the living Jesus. Hallelujah. Can we still be in the attitude of worship? Mm-hmm. Let's begin to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, the one that has brought us to his presence. Let's appreciate him because he's faithful. Faithful is he that has brought us out of darkness into his marvelous light. Father, we worship you. We adore you. Let's commit to this service to God's ends, that God should take preeminent. God should take charge of today's service. That his purpose for our life should be fulfilled today in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we worship you. We give you all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. To be in his presence today is a miracle. In this present time and era, a lot of things are happening in the world, but the Lord is sustaining us. He's keeping us. He's making his face to shine upon us. It's not by our making. Father, we are grateful. We are thankful for everything that you have done in our life. To you be all the glory. To you be all the honor. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Jehovah God. Be thou exalted. Be thou magnified. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. We hail you, we honor you, we hail you, Most High. Can we lift up our voice and worship the King of Kings? Let's praise him, let's appreciate him this morning. He's the Most High God, he's the Lily of the Valley, he's the Bright and the Morning Star. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. The everlasting God, the ever-living God, the ever-faithful God, the all-sufficient God. Lord, we hail you this morning. We honor you this morning. We worship you this morning. Hallelujah. Be thou exalted, O Lord. We hail you. We worship you. Hail the Lord your maker. Hail the
him for what he's about to do in your life. Hail him because he's the Lord of lords, the Prince of kings, the Lord our maker, the everlasting God, the merciful God, the one that rules in the affairs of man, the God that can do all things. We hail you this morning. We hail you this morning. We hail you, Lord. Oh, we hail you, Lord.
We worship you.
We worship you.
We hail you.
Oh, we hail you, Lord. Oh, we worship you. to the Most High God. Welcome your neighbor this morning. You are welcome to the presence of the Most High God. Welcome, welcome, welcome. If you are happy to be in His presence today, let's appreciate the Most High God. Let's give Him all the praise. Let's give Him all the glory. Amen. presence is your blessing, is your favor, is your goodness, is your kindness, is your goodness that makes me run into your presence.
My helper,
you are my helper.
My helper,
my helper.
My helper,
you are my helper.
My helper,
my helper.
My helper.
There is
something that makes me come into your presence. My
Jehovah.
You are the Most High.
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 We worship you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We thank you for the opportunity that you have given us to worship at your feet. We give you all the glory. Be thou exalted, O Lord. Be thou magnified, O Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to your name, O Lord. I will worship you forever. Love you forever.
Presence of God, there is fullness of joy. I want us to thank God with the life of our choir. Let's just put our hands together. It's been wonderful this morning. They have brought down the kingdom of God. We just want to thank God Almighty. I want to say good morning to everyone here in the church auditorium and all watching online. We welcome ourselves once again by the grace of God, not by our power, but by His mercy. And we are not taking it for granted. We want to thank God mightily for all that we have done and all we are still going to do. We say, blessed be your holy name, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. The announcements remain the same. By the grace of God, today is Sunday. We have come to rejoice in the presence of God. And nothing is going to stop us by the grace of God. We'll rejoice and we'll give Him all that He deserves. And He will pour abundance of blessings unto us. In the name of Jesus, amen. Tuesday is another day, Bible study, please. You know, I myself, I'm feeling a little bit guilty. You know, please, let's come and learn. And learn the word of God is the key, you know. Devil, that's what, you know, devil trembles when we are loaded with the word of God. And that's what we need. So let's come and learn. And every day we learn. We don't stop learning until we go back to God. Let's come on Tuesday here in the church auditorium, 7 p.m. And on Thursday, we have a faith clinic, 7 p.m., but that's going to be on phone. So let's not forget to, you know, to join on, to log on. And then our prayers, we remind us every morning, 5 a.m., except Saturdays, we have our prayers online, 5 a.m. It's good to pray. Corporate prayers, they go a long way. And then 12 noon, we have our prayers too. And 12 midnight, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, for 12 midnight, we have our prayers. Let's come together. Let's log on. Almighty God will remove all obstacles from our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. This is going to be for workers, I suppose. This is this coming next week, Sunday, is going to be the third Sunday. And usually we have a workers' prayer meeting. So please, prepare to wait after church service next week, Sunday, because we're going to be together to have a workers' meeting. And Almighty God will help us to come together in the name of Jesus as vessels of honor in His presence, in His hand. We will not be vessels of dishonor in the name of Jesus. Amen. I don't think there's any other announcement, but if there is, Father in the Lord will bring it across to us. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God has done so much for us. We are alive up till today. It's by the grace of God. You have testimonies you want to share. You have seen the pastor. You can come out and share your testimony while we rejoice with you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Testifiers in the house, we have any? Stand up, come majestically. Come and give your testimony.
Lord, pray, Master Jesus. Amen. Good
morning, brothers and sisters. Good morning, family. Good morning. I'm here again to testify to the goodness of God. Thursday the 11th, the Lord added 1 year to my life. Amen. I'm now 81. Oh, Lord, you are so good. Blessed be your name. America, as I always say, God bless America, because he has been, America has been good for me, as the Lord is also good for me too. And 3 years ago, I started thinking, I said, let me go back to Nigeria. I was worried that day. I said, let us go. The house is too big. I'm always going to the hospital. How can I be taking care of the house? Because I don't want dirtiness in the house. That same week, I don't know what happened. I was admitted again in the hospital. As they were discharging me, they brought one lady to me. They said she's going home with me to be my my helper. Oh, wow. I said, home method. I said, perhaps the Lord doesn't want me to go to Nigeria anymore. So the woman came with me to the house. She is so good to me. She's a Jamaican lady. I know when you are good to anyone, that person will be good to you too. She's just like my junior sister. She could have been coming with me to the church, but she's a good Christian. She's a choir in the church. So I said, Sunday will be free for you. Oh, Lord, you are so good.
Blessed be your name.
Lord, you are so good. Blessed be your name.
Praise the Lord. Praise, praise, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Aoye King Dupa. Opeye O Baba. And honor to Almighty God for his, my life today. God added another a year to me. I give glory and honor to Almighty God for the Church of God for celebrating me, all the women, all the sisters, all the daddies in the house. I really appreciate you. God bless you all. Thank you so much.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God is good all the time. Hey, isn't mommy looking so young at 81? Oh, wow. And our lovely sister, too. We want to thank God. I want you to, let's just pray for the testifiers. If you can be on your feet, fine. If you can't, it's okay. Let's stretch out our hands and pray for the testifiers. that Almighty God that has brought them this far. God is so good, he's so merciful, he's so gracious, that God will add many, many, many more years to their life with divine health in the mighty name of Jesus. They will fulfill destiny. Their life will not be cut short in the name of Jesus. The glory of God and the mercy of God and the peace of God will always be theirs in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. We cover the testimonies with the blood of Jesus and we say it is well in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. If you're happy to be in God's presence, shout hallelujah. So we want to pray this morning, and I pray the Lord will help us in our prayers in Jesus' name. I just want to read to us Ephesians chapter 6. Because I want us to pray some powerful prayers. Hallelujah. And we serve a powerful God. He will hear us. He will answer us in the name of Jesus. Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 10. It says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord. So in the place of prayer, we come to God as ourselves. We come to God the way we are with the hope that he will do what only him can do. So when the Bible says, be strong in the Lord. If you're here today, you are not strong in the Lord. As we're going to be praying, strength will come upon you. In the name of Jesus. So he went further to say, be strong in the Lord. And in the power of his might. There is power. There's so many things we have not enjoyed or we have not benefited. The power that is in the name of Jesus. As we pray, that power will come upon us. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. And verse 11 says, put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Verse 12 says, for we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Let's stand on our feet. There are powers, but we know the power in the name of Jesus is greater than every power. Every power that has held you bound, they will let you go. In the name of Jesus. Every forces that is battling against the purpose and the calling of God upon your life, by the power in the name of Jesus, the Lord will destroy them. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yeshua HaMashiach, Lion of Judah. Agone chemba Yeshua HaMashiach, Lion of Judah. Agone chemba Yeshua. Lion of Judah, Lion of Judah. Kadada bashade de bragayada. Shemba. Yeshua. Amasia. Lion of Judah. Oh Jesus, Jesus, we call on you, we call on you, we call on you, we call on you. Makaya da da da, Yeshua. to call upon the name of the Lord. Say, oh Lord, my God, you are the Lion of Judah. You are the great I am. Oh Lord, I call upon your name this morning. Arise and help me. Arise and strengthen me. Are you weak in your spirit? Ask God to strengthen you. You need the power of his might. Call on him. Somebody pray. Every weakness in my spirit. Every weakness in my spirit. Lord, I receive strength. I receive strength. I receive strength. Oh my God and my Father, we call on you, we call on you, we call on you. Makade de bo shagaya gayagada. Hey, da da sabraha. Hey, talera o shayala. Let strength enter us. Oh Lord, strengthen us. Oh Lord, strengthen us. Mande de bo sha. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. There's a level the Lord wants to take us to. He said, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. When you get to that level, you are strong in the Lord and the power of his might. There's some things the devil will not bring your way. Some of the things that is going on in our life that we are experiencing as children of God is not supposed to be so. Because we are not strong in the Lord and we are not equipped in the power of his might. When that power comes upon you, something will naturally go. Some things cannot stay when the power of God is richly dwelling inside of you. Oh, you're going to pray that prayer again. Say, my Father, my Father. Say, my Father, my Father. Everything in me that needs to go by the power in the name of Jesus. Let them begin to go now. Let the power of God enter me. Pray. Power of God, enter me. Power of God, enter me. Oh, pray. Let the power of God enter me. That everything that needs to go, everything that needs to disappear, let it disappear. By the power in the name of Jesus. By the power in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Let the power of God enter me now. Power of God enter me now. Everything in my body that is not supposed to be there. Ayalalo shaka bragada. Mane bro so telegeye gede. E prakabada. Mande de bo shaka. Akata lelegede. E praso niya la kata lago shaka. Reka bragada bo si praha. Leka dede de sha. Mande di prakande dega. Oh, power of God. Enter me now. 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 That everything in my life that needs to go, that is remaining by the power. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Some of us, we are too gentle in the spirit. The devil will be doing things around you, in your family, and you are taking it lightly. He said, we wrestle not against flesh and blood. There's some things you call ordinary. They are not ordinary. That conflict that sometimes comes between you and your husband, sometimes you just casualize it. This man ain't the hear word. This woman ain't the hear word. But you have been taking it all spiritually. Oh, you are going to pray. You see, the Bible said the violent take it by force. He said, who can go to the house of a strong man and take his good? You don't just go there, you know, you have to look for the stronger power. You need to bind that strong man. Then you can take what is yours. I don't know, God wants us to still pray this prayer again. Because this is your season of deliverance. The Lord will deliver you. The Lord will set you free. In the name of Jesus. From every spiritual wickedness. Do you think it's everybody that is happy to see you smiling?
Do you think it's everybody that is happy to see you rejoicing? Me, I've seen someone. I don't know. Something just say turn. I just see the person just doing me like this. Koro, koro. I say, what did I do this person? So it's not everybody that is happy seeing what God is doing in your life. Every spiritual wickedness, the one from my father's side. Some of you, if you don't believe the prayer, some of these days now we have a lot of teaching. Some people don't believe in spiritual wickedness. It's all those things. Once you are born again, all those things just go. There's some things you have to be intentional about. Yes, you are born again, you have the power, but you have to be intentional. Bible says, my people perish for lack of knowledge. You see it happen to your father. You see it happen to your father's brother. And you, now, you are looking at it. And you're saying, I'm born again. It will not happen to me. It's as good as it is. You have to tackle it. You have to be intentional in your prayer. And say, Lord, this thing, it must end with me. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Is somebody ready to pray? Because you shall be free from every spiritual wickedness that is operating in your life, in the life of your children, in your household, by the power, by the authority, in the name of Jesus, the Lord will destroy them. Turn it to prayer, turn it to prayer, turn it to prayer. Let the Lord destroy every spiritual wickedness, every principalities, every powers. Every powers, every strongholds of the enemy against your life, against your children, it shall not stand. In the by the power, by the authority, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we destroy every stronghold of the enemy. We destroy every stronghold of the wicked. Oh, somebody pray that prayer. The Lord is setting you free from every stronghold, from every powers of darkness, from your lineage, from your father's side, from your mother's side. Every power tormenting your life, every power saying no to your destiny. Yes, yes, the Lord is bringing deliverance. He's bringing liberation. You shall be free. You shall be free. You shall be free. You shall be, hey, pray, 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 pray. Oh Lord my Father, arise, destroy the works of the enemy in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Even Christ said, for this purpose I came, that I might destroy the works of the wicked, the works of the enemy. Every works of the enemy in your life, they shall be destroyed. If you believe it, say it louder, amen. If you believe it, say it louder, amen. If you believe it, say it louder, amen. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We want to pray, lastly, that the Lord, by the power of God, every spiritual wickedness going on in our world, every spiritual wickedness, you see, the why you need to tackle spiritual wickedness, even the streets you are, there is a prince of that street. That, you see, if you want to know, if you want to do some, you know, spiritual research, Go to all the houses that is in your street or the place you live. You see that there's some peculiar things that is happening to everybody in that area. There's a prince and power of America that want to influence our life, influence our children, but they will not prevail. They will not prevail. They will not prevail. That is why we are praying. That is why we need to pray, even for this land. We are going to pray, say, Father, every power every power in the air, in the land, in the sea, that is controlling wickedness, that is sponsoring wickedness in this land. Every power of darkness that is sponsoring wickedness in my vicinity, in my area, it will not come near my dwelling place. Oh Lord, we come against every power of darkness. Prayer in the name of Jesus. We come against every power of darkness, even in this place, in this church where we are located. Every power of darkness in this area that is sponsoring wickedness, we come against them in the name of Jesus. We ask, oh God, by the authority in the name of Jesus, every power of darkness waging war against our life, against our children, even against this nation, every power of darkness sponsoring wickedness, sponsoring evil, we come against you in the name of Jesus. We come against you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. The Lord will strengthen us. The Lord will help us. Please, in these last days, if they call for prayer meeting, attend. He said, when you are strong in the power of his mind, you will be able to withstand the wiles of the devil, the arrows that the enemy is shooting. You don't want to be a casualty. You don't want to just allow anything to come. There are some people, the devil will shoot arrow, it will enter. They will not start praying for it to go out. But there are some, when they shoot the thing, what will happen? Back to sender. Because you are strong in the Lord, in the power of his might. Please don't play with your prayer life. The Lord will strengthen us. And the church, thank God for a church like this. They have avenues of prayer. 5 a.m. prayer. Anyone you can join, join. And the Lord will continue to strengthen you. The Lord will continue to strengthen you. Even in your own individual life, build an altar of prayer. Be praying. And the Lord will continue to strengthen us in the mighty name of Jesus. I want you to begin to pray and say, Father, as I continue the service of this morning, Lord, visit me. Lord, remember me. Lord, locate me. As your word will comfort, your word will comfort with power. Lord, you will deliver. You will strengthen me. You will liberate me through your word that will comfort. Lord, we commit the rest of the service this morning into your hands. We ask, oh God, that you have your way. We ask, oh God, that you take control. Thank you, everlasting Father. Receive all the praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. If you believe the Lord has answered your prayer, shout a louder amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Let's all rise up for our congregational hymn. Deeper, deeper in the love of Jesus. Jesus, daily let me go. Bless the Lord in thy precious holy.
Amen. I pray that the Lord will take us deeper, wiser, holier in his word in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. The Lord will continue to help us to move closer, closer, closer to him in the name of Jesus. Amen. So shall it be in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. It's time to appreciate our maker once again with our substances, with our money, with all that he has blessed us with. This is the time to appreciate him once again that I count us worthy to witness today, to be among the living. We are not in the mortuary, we are in the sanctuary, and we are here in the sanctuary to bless him with all that he has given unto us. You don't have envelope, wave your hands so that the ushers will give you one. You need an envelope, you are going to drape your offering, that you are going to put in your check. Wave your hands so that the ushers will give you one. For the benefit that as many that want to send our money to the church account, especially those that are viewing from home, you can send it to the church account, which is RCCG Restoration Palace at gmail.com. RCCG Restoration Palace at gmail.com. Or you want to mail your check to the church address, you can mail it to 2277 Southern Boulevard, Bronx, New York, 10460. The Lord bless you as you do that in the name of Jesus. Amen. We are going to raise up our money, your devices that you want to use to sell your money, plus please, as many that are viewing us from home, please try to obey this instruction anytime we are giving our offering. Anything that you are going to use to sell your money, if it is your computer, place your hand on top of your computer and begin to, you know, tell all that you want. And the Lord will honor everything that concerning your life in the name of Jesus. Begin to tell God all that you want, all that you don't want in your life, everything that is not good in your finances, everything that is not good in your life, that as you are giving unto the Lord this day, God of heaven, remove them in the name of Jesus. Every spirit that is not allow me to enjoy the work of my hand, or that is not enjoy the blessing, that is not making me to enjoy the blessing that God has that put in place for my life, that God of heaven, because I'm giving unto you and I'm being faithful in paying my tithe, King of glory, begin to remove it in the name of Jesus. Father, destroy everything that is eating my money. King of glory, destroy in the name of Jesus. Father, King of glory, let it be so in the name of Jesus. And as many that we are faithful, bless us in the name of Jesus. Replenish all our purses in the name of Jesus. Father, King of glory, we appreciate you. We bless you in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. And we appreciate us to be on our feet and give cheerfully this morning as I'm going to hand over to the choir while they're going to give us a danceable song. Amen.
Can we please all rise up on our feet? Have you heard what the Lord has done? He has destroyed the works of Satan. He has given us the victory. That's why we sing, we say it. Yeah.
minister, you are blessed in the name of Jesus. You continue to go higher, higher, and higher in the name of Jesus. Amen. Kingdom sister, if you are in the house, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. If you want to join the group, you are welcome. But we know ourselves as kingdom sisters. Hallelujah. Amen. This is the offering of your people. God, Heavenly Father, bless it in the name of Jesus. And let it be used for the propagation of your work on this planet Earth in the name of Jesus. As many, O Lord, that they want to give at this time. But because of one reason or the other, they couldn't do it. King of Glory, our provider, go and provide for their needs in the name of Jesus. Provide for their needs in the name of Jesus. So that by this time when they come to your presence, they will be able to give unto you in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the living Jesus. Please join me if you can as I sing a special number. It's called Speak the Name. And may you be blessed as you listen.
Amen. The atmosphere is changing. Nothing stays the same. The heaven is waiting for the mention of the name. The Spirit is moving, burning like a flame, healing the broken by the one we proclaim. Raising up, fill the sky. The name.
pray that Almighty God will continue to give more grace to our sister in the mighty name of Jesus. Your voice that you are using to praise God, enemy will not spoil it in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. We want to welcome every one of you back to the house of God. The psalmist said he was always glad whenever he was told to come to the house of God. Please always be happy to come to the house of God. And by the time you return home, you become happier in Jesus' name. We want to remind us of our activities for the week by the special grace of God, because the Bible enjoins us that we have to be reminding ourselves. Please, all the programs for the week, let's try to attend, and the Lord will bless us in Jesus' name. Do we have anybody worshiping with us for the first time? Any visitor, guests? If today is your first Sunday in our midst, anybody? Okay, so there is none. Let's try to invite our friends, neighbors, co-workers, even our enemies, because God is for everybody, is for all nations. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. And also, we want us to know that towards the end of the service today, we are going to pray for our outgoing ESCO members in all our fellowships, men, women, and the Yasim, and we will equally welcome and also pray for the incoming ones as well. And please, for our brethren at the technical, when it is time, or audio, or section, or whatever the name of your section is now, please, when it is time for that, we don't want it to be streamed, so it's not like part of the service. That is our own internal activities. So please, and of course, it's going to be the last assignment to be done. So maybe after we share the grace, so we can make sure that we don't stream it. Many of us that we are social media experts, please, we beg you, you don't want it on YouTube. Please, you can have it for your own personal consumption if you want, but don't. And obedience, please, is very, very important. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. And we also want the Kingdom Sisters to know that there will be their prayer meeting on the 21st of this month at 8 p.m. So please let them attend, and Almighty God is going to bless you as you attend in the mighty name of Jesus. Are we going to sing this old song? Well, let us pray. Father Eternal, we bless you. Coming to your presence is a miracle on its own. In fact, it's one of the mothers of miracles, if not the most mother of miracle. I want to thank you, Almighty God, for bringing us to your presence, and we are not taking it for granted. This morning, please receive our thanks in Jesus' name. From the knowledge of your word, we also know bringing us to your presence itself is not an end, but a means to an end. Because the Bible says you are going to satisfy us with the goodness of your house, even of your holy temple. I pray that today, every blessings, as we thank you for the blessings we have received so far, even the remaining blessings you have for us shall not elude us in the name of Jesus. I come against every force, every power, every demon, because also from the knowledge of the word of God, you are disobedient spirits. Even though you know you're supposed not to come, but because you are disobedient, you will still want to come. Therefore, peradventure, you are hiding anywhere. I use that name, the name that you know and that you fear and that you tremble, the name of Jesus, wherever you are hiding. I drive you out in the name of Jesus. From that heart, come out in the name of Jesus. Every word that twists the word of God, every word that we begin to say is their own, that's not for me. You are the voice of the devil. I come against you. This very morning, move out in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. The blessings we are going to receive shall be remain permanent with us. In Jesus' wonderful name, we have prayed. Praise the Lord. We are soldiers fighting for the Lord. In the name of Jesus, we shall conquer. We are so marching for the in the name of Jesus, we shall conquer. Are you a soldier? So fighting for the Lord, fighting for the Lord. In the name of Jesus, we shall conquer. We are soldiers fighting for the Lord, fighting for the Lord. In the name of Jesus, we shall sing it once again. We are soldiers fighting for the Lord. In the name of Jesus, we shall conquer. That chorus is more than a song. It's a prophecy. And you are declaring that you shall conquer. And you shall conquer in the name of Jesus. You shall not be a victim in the name of Jesus. Whatever battle that you are fighting, victory is yours in the name of Jesus. So shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Exodus chapter 17. Exodus in chapter 17. Beginning from verse 8. Exodus 17, starting from verse 8. Then came Amalek and fought with Israel in Rephidim. And Moses said unto Joshua, choose us out men and go out and fight with Amalek. Tomorrow I will stand on the top of the hill with the rod of God in my hand. So Joshua did as Moses had said to him, and fought with Amalek. And Moses and Aaron and all went up to the top of the hill. Verse 11. And it came to pass, when Moses held up his hand, that Israel prevailed. And when Moses, or when he let down his hand, Amalek prevailed. But Moses' hands were heavy. And they took a stone and put it under him. And he sat thereon. And Aaron and Hur stayed up his hands, the one on the one side and the other on the other side. And his hands were steadily until the going down of the sun. And Joshua discomfited Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword. Verse 16. And the Lord said unto Moses, write this for a memorial in a book, and rehearse it in the ears of Joshua. For I will utterly put out of the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. This morning, I want to speak on what I call soldiers of the Lord. By default, as believers in Christ, you are a soldier of Christ, not minding your gender. That is, whether you are a man or you are a woman. In fact, regardless of your age, not to talk of your position in the house of God, you are a soldier of Christ. Can somebody say, I'm a soldier of Christ? Say it again. You are a soldier of Christ. The primary purpose of a soldier, of course, is battle. Is to defend his nation against external aggressors. You are a soldier of Christ to defend the nation of God, to defend Christianity, to defend the work of God against external aggressors. In the passage that we just read, we found even the Amalekites, they initiated the battle against the nation of Israel under the leadership of Moses. And we thank God for various soldiers that we found in that passage, including Moses. Everybody did something. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Everybody did something. As a soldier of Christ, you have your own position in the battle of the Lord. You have your own position to fight against the enemy of the work of God. The Bible likens us to be spiritual house, and that individual is a living stone or a living block that make up a temple or a house. So you are very important. Can you say to yourself that I am very important in the kingdom of God, in the battle of God? You are very important. Back to the passage that we read. We have been told that Moses, in verse 9, said unto Joshua, Choose out men, and go out, fight with Amalek. Tomorrow I will stand on the top of the hill with the rod of God in my hand. So that verse alone introduces you to division of labor in the battle of God. Every finger cannot be thumbed. Everybody has his own place, and everybody is very important. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Moses didn't choose the soldiers that will go and fight the battle. He delegated that to Joshua to do. Go out. You will be outside there facing the Amalekites. I and others will be on the top of the hill. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. So, in the battle that we are fighting, or in the war that we are fighting, just a function of semantics, some might say battle, war, might say in a war, we have series of battles, whether battles, better war. One thing that runs through all of them is that there is a kind of a contention. There is a kind of a struggle. There's a kind of a force that we are contending with. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Spiritual battles. Maybe we should start from there. The Bible says we fight not against flesh or blood, but against spiritual powers in high places. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. That is in the book of Ephesians in chapter 6. Our battle is not physical, so to say, though that doesn't mean there's no physical battle there, but mostly they are spiritual. Look at what the Bible says, Ephesians in chapter 6. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against spiritual wickedness. Verse 12. Ephesians 6, verse 12. You know, against principalities, powers, rulers of the darkness of this world, spiritual wickedness in high places. It's like many of us, maybe we are not aware of the forces that we are co-fighting. You know, God is with us. Jesus is with us. Holy Spirit is with us. Those are the forces that we are fighting. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. And you have to identify the enemy that you are fighting. In 1 Corinthians, in chapter 9, 1 Corinthians, in chapter 9, Paul said that, yes, in verse 26, I did run. Or he said, I therefore so run, not as uncertainly, so fight I not as the one beating the air. In other words, he knew the enemy that he was fighting. And use the appropriate, you know, weapons to fight them. Don't use a sledgehammer to kill a fly. Use the appropriate. Know what you are fighting. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. So, as a nation of God, the enemy is fighting us. Satan is fighting us. The world is fighting us. Cohorts of the devil, principalities, powers, spiritual wickedness in high places, rulers of the darkness of this world, they are all in battle with us. But as the Lord liveth, we are winners in the mighty name of Jesus. I say we are winners in the mighty name of Jesus. Because the battle that we are actually fighting is the battle that the Lord has won for us. And victory shall continually be ours in the mighty name of Jesus. So therefore, there was or there is delegation of duty in the battle of the Lord. A tree does not make a forest. Everybody must identify his own role and he must carry it out. That's number one. Then number two, the battle that we are fighting, we have to fight it, you know, cooperatively, not competitively. That is, we have to join forces together. We have to synergize our strength together. One shall chase 1,000, but two shall put 10,000 to flight. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. In Genesis, in chapter 11, you know the story beginning from verse 1, whereby people there demonstrated the force of unity and what force of unity could achieve. Even people trying to do contrary to the will of God. Even God himself did not mince words to underscore the importance of unity. So we need to unify ourselves. In unity, we stand. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. I say God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. So one, division of labor. Two, unity. Then three, you have to identify the enemy that you are fighting. Don't just beat the ear. Let's take Israel and Iran, the recent war now that is going on. When Iran shot their rockets and the other artillery against Israel, they told them, in another 9 hours, we are expecting them. And what are they doing? They were expecting, and whatever they could stop, they did. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. People of God, whether you realize it or not, battle is going on. This world is a battle. Tell the brother, sister, sister, he said, this world is a battle. Please, so it's a battle. Yes. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. But again, we are going to win in the mighty name of Jesus. We are winners in the mighty name of Jesus. So the Bible told us that Moses now went to the top of the hill. Top of the hill is a phrase for, you know, being in a place of prayer, in a spiritual level, you know, of course, that is relevant for the situation at that time. He was on the top of the mountain. Joshua and others, they are like the footmen. They are like the army, you know. Maybe you want to say, you know, Moses is now like airmen or the air force or whatever. But in the spiritual realm there. Say, just go. You be doing the battle. I raise up my hands with the sword of God in my hand. And the Bible said, as long as the hands of Moses stayed up, there will be victory. But on the other hand, if the hand lowered, then the enemy will prevail. The hands of our leader will not come down in the mighty name of Jesus. And you see, the greater amen to that is what we find here. Thank God for her. Thank God for Aaron. They quickly noticed that, it's like our own department is to do what? To raise up the hands of Moses. They didn't say they will raise up their own hand, though. You know, they could have said, Moses is like, you are outdated too. You are too old. Let me raise my own hand. So just keep your own hand in the pocket. Hey, thank God that mistake was not made. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. But rather, you see, nowadays, many of us, we want our hands to be raised. And we don't know there is still a way we can still achieve the same purpose. Whoever God has put there, do what? Raise up their hands. Whether you like it or not, a time may come, the hand we want to come down. And that is why you are there. To do what? To raise it up. Not only that, they even told Moses, look at it very carefully. You know, Moses said in verse 10, you know, that he will go, you know, to the top of the mountain. You see, he will stand. Look at it in verse 9. He said, I will stand on the top of the hill. Not sit, but stand on the top of the hill. With his hands up. But it got to a point,
It's not only the hand that was sick, maybe even the leg too is paining Moses. They say two things, Moses, sit down. Number one. Then number two, your hands will still be up. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, Joshua at the forefront together with whatever numbers of other soldiers were there fighting the Amalekites. Whenever, you know, the Amalekites like was having the upper hand, they might not know what was going on, that maybe until they were told, they wouldn't know that it was, Moses' hand coming down. And anytime the thing went up, they might think, oh, we are the one doing. They didn't know the secret of the victory is the Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. You see, what is keeping this building strong? Essentially, you may not see it. It's right in the ground. The background of anything is the life of any structure. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. So nobody saw Moses where he was. Nobody saw her and Aaron where they were. People could only say, hey, Joshua, ha, ho. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Her and Aaron, we are doing their job. Assuming they shirk in their duties, the consequence will have been, of course, defeat for the Israelites. And it's going to be a communal defeat. You see? A communal one. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. But thank God, they rose up to lift up the hands of Moses. You see, at a point I was thinking, what about their own hands too? Are they not feeling the pain? One way or the other, God will supply the strength. God will supply the grace. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. In the battle of God, everybody is important. We are members of the body of Christ. Like I used to say, no part of your body is more important than the other. Your mouth is not more important than anus. In fact, when anus is supposed to speak, if he doesn't speak, when we go to hospital, you know what that means? Aha! The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. And what the anus will say, the mouth cannot say it. And vice versa. Every part of the body is important. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. So therefore, where am I going, people of God? This is the time that we have to walk together as one. A wise saying in my culture says, the reason why people kill snake is because snake walk singly, alone. If 300 snakes are coming now, Brahma, are you going to wait? He said, don't say, Pastor, don't ask me. What about you? Me too, I go run, no. We look for some protection. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. But if it is one, even some of us might say, we might even want to tramp on it. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. That is the power of unity. Praise the Lord. When we walk together as one, well, the Bible says one, we chase 1,000, and two, we put 10,000 to flight. It is true. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. There's somebody here, you are a student. God says the reason why you have not overcome that particular problem is because you are fighting it alone. Try to share that problem with your classmates. You'll be surprised. You'll be surprised. And I didn't see that angle. And there's no way you will see that angle. Because the Lord has set up standard. You know, things that we make. There's a time you have to walk together. Yes. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. And this is the time to walk together as one. And I pray that Almighty God, He will help you. He will help me. And we will do our own part in the mighty name of Jesus. So Joshua discomfited Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword. But nobody knew that very staff that was raised up somewhere in the secret. Nobody saw Hur and Aaron that in the secret they were doing something. Now listen. Yes, your own ministry may not be the overt one, the public one. It might be something that is, you know, in the secret. But there is a God that sees in secret that will reward you openly. Because what is important is that everyone should contribute his own quota. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. It's so easy to blame our leaders. It's so easy to blame our heads. But what are we doing to help them? Let me borrow a leaf from my culture again. They say the way people mill around to carry a cursed man to be buried. If they mill around that person when he was sick, maybe he wouldn't have died. You see the culture of nowadays, especially in a particular country in Africa now. If an accident happens, inside for people to rescue the person that is injured, it's their phone. You know? I will be the first one to get it and send it on YouTube. Nobody cares about the life that is heading out. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Everybody's like, want to take, I don't know what kind of glory is that anyways. Ha! People of God, this is the time, especially the church of God, we have to wake up. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. We are tired of bench warmers. In your fellowship, you have to be doing something. Yes. I didn't recognize that until recently when I needed something to do, you know, at my, you know, my association back at home. I mean, I was called to bar over 20 years now, 25 years now, because I didn't live much in Nigeria. I thought all my dues every year, I didn't. Yes. But when I needed something to do, they said, okay, you said you are from this. We want to see. And when I also, they say, but we look at the record. We haven't seen your diesel. Because we are going to answer to you, at least go back 5 years. I say, my God, have mercy. And I have to. People of God, the point is that they don't want you just to be ordinary member. You have to be a card carrying, a due pay members. Maybe somebody is saying, I hope you have paid your fellowship dues. I say, Pastor, don't go there. I will go there. Because it's part of, it's relevant to the message. You have to help your fellowship. The Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. Mother's Day, Father's Day, around the corner, all those things, they chop money. Let's even leave Mother's Day or Father's Day. I mean, we have to support ourselves. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. So the Bible told us Joshua defeated the Amalekites not by the strength of Joshua himself. Of course, his skill, his knowledge, he's been a military man or whatever, very important. But all those alone wouldn't have brought victory to Israel. Everybody, one way or the other, contributed. Even there are some that they didn't mention. In this passage, I believe they contributed their own quota as well. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. See, we are moving to the era that, you see, devil is working, seriously working against unity in the church of God. If you go and read the story of Uriah, the husband of Bathsheba, how, you know, he actually died. You will see that the main cause of his death was because when he needed people around him, he didn't find any. In fact, the instruction that was given was not only that he should be sent to where the battle was hottest, one, but that's not determinative. He could have gone there and still come back. All right, but more important, he said, when he was there, then the rest of you come back from him. Ha! Isn't that not happening in the battle of heaven, battle of God today? The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Please, if it is happening, it should not continue. This is the time that, listen, you can go to your departmental head. You can go to your pastor. You can go to, you know, your group head. I want to do something. What can I do? Or you can even come with your ideas. We want this thing to move forward. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank God for our daddy you. Years ago when he came to Redeem Church, the same way you and I came to Redeem Church. Today, I think the nations of the world, they are about 95. Redeem Church is 190. Sorry, did I say 95? They are 190 or 195. The Redeem Church is in over 190 nations. Of course, a tree doesn't make a forest. We are not saying that daddy is now omnipresent. Not that daddy is every nation, every Nigeria, in America, and UK, all at the same time. No! But at least thank God for that vision. And thank God that, you know, recently I was reading the open heaven, daddy said the time that he starts working is 5 a.m. at that age, every morning. And one thing that I know about our daddy with all respect is that daddy still has to do prayer work, maybe 3 a.m., maybe 2 a.m. People of God, this is the time. Don't be satisfied with just being there doing nothing. Do something. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. You see, you don't have to be, you know, an officer. You don't have to be a particular title before you can do something. No, you don't have to. And mind you, God take cognizance of what you are doing for the work of God. And he's the one that will reward you. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. This is the time our own nation is facing the Amalekites. Different kind of Amalekites that we are facing. And this is the time we need to put our resources together to fight them. Amalekites that is fighting against your home. You as a husband, you as a wife, or even children without your parents, you cannot do it alone. Of course, everybody needs his own little quota, his own wisdom, his own suggestion, his own part to take, but concerted effort is the key. We all need it now. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. And I pray that as we are fighting the battle of God, victory shall be ours in the mighty name of Jesus. Your own may be a gift or vision. Maybe any time before you even close your eyes, you begin to have good dreams. I'm not talking of a fabricated ones, like if you soak your gari with water and later you find yourself now swimming. Please, that one already started before you sleep anyways. You know? But there are some revelations that you know. You may have a revelation about somebody. Pray for that very person. You can even take a step forward, let your leader know, so that we can put hands together. You see, there are so many things happening to us nowadays, they are preventable. But you know, people, maybe you haven't heard about, people like when something happened to somebody. Yes, I saw it. I knew about it. But what did you do? Nothing. We don't want that kind of coming out. You keep it to yourself. If when you saw it, you didn't do anything, you didn't pray, you didn't notify the person, to be forewarned is to be forehanded. What did you do? God revealed it to you to do what? To do something. That idea is given to you to do what? To do something. Thank God for so many inventors that we are having nowadays. Though there are very few. Many of us, we are just consumers. We consume, we consume, we consume, we consume. When you leave, what are you going to leave behind? Oh, thank God for Africa. Some things we may not like about Africa, but I'm telling you, go and look at how Africans are doing well nowadays in invention. Hey? Concerning fuel now, scarcity in Nigeria, some they have developed different kind of what you never thought. Some they say water. Some they say I say, oh my God, where were all these things before? Yes. One Nigerian woman developed a brazier that can early detect, you know, maybe anything, all these problems that are common to women. They know we help us in the name of Jesus. And one thing that I discover is this. If you can think, if you are passionate about something, God will speak to you. You start, begin to say, Restoration Palace going forward, even if just 5 minutes every day, I'll be thinking about you. How? What can I do to make this church go forward? What can I do to make my fellowship go forward? What can I do to help this man of God? What can I do to help this brother? What I am telling you, God will speak to you. That's the key. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Exodus chapter 3 is when, you know, Moses not only saw the fire burning and the bush did not burn. But the Bible said he wanted to know why. Then God spoke to him. You see, there's a kind of attitude that we opened up for you. Our watchword for this month, in essence, is talking about open heaven and we will see the vision of God. When you saw the vision of God, what did you do with it? Or when the Lord reveals to you, God wants you to do something. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. And I pray that Almighty God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's bow down our heads and say, Father, as I thank you for enlisting me in your battle. At the same time, Almighty Father, Lord, I don't want to disappoint you. Yes, I have disappointed you in the past, and I'm sorry for that. If I'm repenting of them, please forgive me. And going forward, Almighty God, by your grace, I will do good what I've done bad and better what I've done good. By your grace, Almighty God, I'm going to learn from, you know, Moses, from Joshua, from Aaron, from her, how one way or the other they contributed their own quota to the battle of the Lord. This is my own time. Father, Lord, help me in the name of Jesus. 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 Father, Lord, Father, Lord, Father, Lord, Father, Lord, Father, Lord, I believe your word that you have given unto me all things pertaining to life and godliness. I receive the grace. Is it that very weakness? I receive the grace. Is it that very sin? I receive the grace. Is it that very issue? I receive the grace. Almighty God, all the spiritual battles, I don't care their coalition. I don't care how many forces. I know that in the mighty name of Jesus, with God inside of me, victory is mine. Father, Lord, we thank you. Oh, Lord, we bless you. Oh, Lord, we appreciate you. In Jesus' wonderful name, we have prayed. As you are sitting down, just hold the hand of somebody by your side. I want to pray this prayer. You may not know what that brother or that sister or that man or woman is going through or is facing, or is facing him or her. But we want to pray that this my brother, this my sister that I'm holding, I join my faith with you. Whatever battle that you are facing, victory is just in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever Amalek that you are facing, victory is just in the mighty name of Jesus. Victory is just in the mighty name of Jesus. Victory is just in the mighty name of Jesus. Victory is just in the mighty name of Jesus. Victory is just in the mighty name of Jesus. Victory is just in the mighty name of Jesus. Victory is just in the mighty name of Jesus. Victory is just in the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. In Jesus' wonderful name, we have prayed. If you have not given your life to Christ, please do. Tomorrow may be too late. Salvation is still free. Whosoever comes unto him still shall not be cast away. And it shall be well with you in the mighty name of Jesus. I say, shall be well with you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. Glory and honor be unto your name. Lord of heaven, as we have renewed even our intention, our determination, our decision to be, you know, soldiers of Christ, effective, efficient one, Almighty God, please help us in the mighty name of Jesus. We will help, you know, our brother in whatever capacity that we find ourselves. We will lend out our own helping hand to make sure that, you know, the battle of the Lord does not suffer defeat in the mighty name of Jesus.
Jehovah, Lord, we bless you. In Jesus' wonderful name, we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. Our media people can... and refire and rear and fire. That's how it is. That's it. Refire.
are golden hands, are blessed hands. And let us pray for him. Let's thank God for his life, for how well and how far God is using him. And let's pray that it shall be well with him continually in the mighty name of Jesus. He will not be tired or wearied or be discouraged in doing the work of God. He will continually soar higher in the mighty name of Jesus. And God will always uplift him with his right hand of righteousness in the name of Jesus. When he calls one, like he said, thousands will answer to the call in the mighty name of Jesus. And it shall be well with him, spirit, soul, and body. Shall be well with his wife, his children, grandchildren, and the church of God, and everything that concerns him, even his secular job, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we say thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. And I want you to pray for yourself too, that Almighty God, I want to just say thank you, Lord, for you've been here this morning. You've been a partaker of the good things that happened this day, that the blessings we received will be permanent in our lives in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let us rise up as we share the grace in fellowship. 1, 2, go. Okay, so next week, that's all. Okay, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let us, Pastor, just remind, 2 weeks' time, next week is going to be workers' meeting, then 2 weeks' time is going to be evangelism. Emma, so please get prepared. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's share the grace in fellowship. 1, 2, go. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Our watchword, Ezekiel chapter 1, verse 1 says, now it came to pass in the 30th year, in the fourth month, in the fifth day of the month, as I was going among the captives by the river of Sheba, that the heavens were open and I saw visions of God. May the heavens continually be opened unto us in the name of Jesus. And may we always see visions of God in Jesus' name. Amen. May we go in peace, and may the peace of God be with us in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Workers, can you come to the altar, please?